All right, God, lead me. Whatever it is I'm supposed to say, just let it be said. Because this is the only way I know how to do it right now. And you've had me up since 3:30. In thirst of knowledge. Knowledge about what to do, because I feel like I have been called. Oh, wow. I feel like that you have made it very evident to me without slapping me in the face. So gentlemanlike that everything I've been through is for a reason, and I'm supposed to be a seed planter. I don't know what pedestal or where or why, or this is all so crazy insane to me, but I'm a willing empty vessel, and I keep saying that because I am. And I've really cleaned out all the things, and I don't know what else, where God's leading me. I feel like so many things are happening right now that I cannot explain. Like these things. These sunflowers that I planted bird seed. I was trying to feed my birds, because they were just beautiful to me. And so I planted bird seed, and I just planted it there because I wanted to plant this purple passion vine that has taken, praise God, thank you, hallelujah, because I planted it from over in that window, which is now my prayer office, because it went from an outlet that God gave me last year that I wrote down on a piece of paper and didn't realize I was praying for an outlet. But I didn't. Your heart will speak however it has to speak. No matter how you try to numb it or block it out, your heart is going to speak. I realize this now, because my heart speaks whenever I don't have words. My heart speaks with music or with cooking or with painting. All these new outlets that I was just searching for, they were here, and they were here the whole time, but I just had them blocked out. I was jaded, I say, because I wasn't seeing clearly. My windows were dirty and they needed to be cleaned, and God had me up cleaning windows this morning. I've been up since 3:30, and this is my new prayer spot. This is where God's moved me around really fast. It started right there in my bathroom window. That's where I was praying, and that is my rainy day. Was my rainy day spot, and then it moved me here, and this became my prayer sanctuary, and it still is, and it's where all of these things, the spark to grow all of these things and for all of this. And that's where God made himself real to me, in that very spot where that vine is growing, in that window, which is now my office, because God made himself real to me in there, in an empty room that I used to mop for 3 years, because we kept our dogs in there and they peed and pooped in there every day, and I had to mop every day, and I hated it, and I would be so mad at, why is this my life right here? Why am I having to freaking mop this pee and poop? And the thing was that I didn't have to. I did it because I was stuck in a loop of doing it, and all we had to do was build a doghouse, figure out a different way to get our dogs outside and for where they would have a place to live, and I wouldn't be mopping and poop and pee all day long every day. Well, God turned that place into the spot where he made himself real to me, and where he sparked, he planted a seed in my heart. And it is just growing and growing and growing, like fast, in a hurry. He's been dealing with me my whole life, my whole entire life. And I felt what I feel now when I was a teenager, when I went to a revival in Pensacola, Florida. And it was the Brownsville Revival. I felt these feelings, but I was a teenager and it was scary to me. And I didn't know what to think about what I didn't know if the adults had spiked the punch. I didn't know what was going on in my brain. I was confused, but I was down for the ride. It was fun. We're going on a trip to Florida, and I got something there. And then I feel like the devil went into attack mode. As soon as he recognized that there was a plan for my life then, and which I didn't know then, that there was a plan for my life. I just thought I was a part of something that I was confused about. Now it's been made so very clear to me that all that happened for a reason, because I needed to know that feeling. So whenever I found it again, that I would be sure of what that feeling was and what it meant. Oh, wow. As I say things, I'm revealing them to myself at the same time. And it's been like that my whole life, that things finally just click eventually. Like with the directions, like northwest, south, east. I didn't get that whenever it was taught to me in school. I didn't understand it at all. And then one day, just all of a sudden, whenever I looked at a map, I seen a picture of it, it clicked for me. And I realize now it's because I learn better with pictures, or with actually seeing things happen. And it clicked one day. So all of this just clicked one day for me. And my Bush's Goliath tomato plant, it sparked something in me. And I can't pull this up. It's not producing fruit anymore, but I don't care. This plant taught me something. It is beautiful to me. It means so much to me. And I will not pull this thing up as long as it has green on it and is growing, because it taught me a lesson and it's beautiful. And I'm just doing so much talking all the time, but it's because I feel like God, this is not me. This is not for me. This is not for money. This is not for fame. This is because it is very important for people to know that if you felt this before in your life, don't be confused about what it was. Don't be confused. God is trying to wake his people up. The awakening just keeps going over my head. Like I don't know why. I don't know if I'm brainwashing myself, but yes, I do know why. But I don't have to wonder why in my head what's going on, because I really know what's happening. I understand. I understand now, and I'm just trying to figure it out, but I'm letting God lead me. And I know that he's about to do big things. I can say that in confidence, in my heart. I know that some things are about to happen, because they already are happening. I've been in search of knowledge, and I have been... Oh, wow. I have really been finding out. God's been like confirming all of these things that I've wondered about my whole entire life. And it's up to us to break the cycle, for our kids' sake and for their soul, their eternal soul and sake. And in Jesus' name, we have to do it. So, I am right now. I'm a student, and I'm trying to learn from the Creator. And I feel like it that God wants us to use whatever pedestal that we have, and I may just have this pedestal right here in my yard to just grow things, to grow myself, grow my family, and grow things. But I feel like that we can do all of those things, all the things, and share how we're doing it with the people we love and our family. And you know, whenever you have the same father, then to me that makes you family. And it doesn't matter about blood, but although if you want to talk about blood, we can. Because I'm pretty sure that the father we shared has a lot to do with the blood. Alright, that's what I had to say today. I have to go take care of Chris, cook stuff, get more knowledge about the big plan that God has in store. And I'm just thankful, and I want to thank him right now for making it clear to me that what my purpose is. And I'm ready. I'm ready. I am in search of the fullness of God and ready to share. Thank you, Jesus.
I'm a good old boy, drinking whiskey and rye home. But she carries me.
That's what I like saying. He's been walking around with me for a minute.
All the crazy in my dreams. Both my broken
wings. I love dragonflies.
Every single piece of everything I am. And she knows the man I am. She forgives me when I can. The devil man.
This is my favorite color, too, by the way. This is amazing. It's my friend, y'all.
Yeah, she knows the man I am. She